continue our pilgrimage to the Arch Basilica of San Giovanni in Laterano, defined also as the mother of all the churches in the world. It is the oldest and the highest ranking of all the four major papal basilicas, holding the unique title of Arch Basilica. Commissioned by the Emperor Constantine and consecrated by Pope Sylvester in AD 324, it was the first Christian basilica built in Rome. It is still Rome's official cathedral and the Pope's seat as the Bishop of Rome. The basilica gets its name from the Lateran hill on which it is built. Initially dedicated to Christ the Savior, the basilica was twice rededicated, first in the 10th century to St. John the Baptist and again in the 12th century to St. John the Evangelist. The basilica has played an important role throughout the history. It was here that all popes were enthroned up until 1870. The Lateran Palace served as the residence of the popes for about a millennium until the seat ultimately moved to the Vatican. This art piece in front of the basilica tells the story of Saint Francis of Assisi seeking the approval of Pope Innocent III for their way of life in 1209. Throughout the centuries, it has survived several fires, looting, and earthquakes. However, it maintains its first form, even though it has been renovated on several occasions. The one that we see in front of us today is the fourth church erected between 1660 and 1730. The facade, as it appears today, was completed in 1735. The abbreviated Latin inscription translates as Pope Clement XII, in the fifth year of his pontificate, dedicated this building to Christ the Savior in honor of St. John the Baptist and John the Evangelist. We can also see the statues of the Savior, John the Baptist, John the Evangelist, and the 12 doctors of the Greek and Latin churches. In the narthex of the church is a 4th century statue of Emperor Constantine. The central door is made of bronze panels acquired from the ancient Roman Curia. The basilica has 5 naves with a wide transept and huge apse. In the niches along the central nave, there are the statues of the apostles made in the early 1700s. The statues, the painting, and the architecture seem to express the idea that the church, whose cornerstone is Christ, is built on the foundation of the apostles and the prophets. We can also notice several chapels along the outermost side aisles. This is the altar of the sacrament. According to traditions, the precious reliquary above the altar of the sacrament contains a fragment of the table at which Jesus and the apostles had the Last Supper. In the center of the transept is the Gothic canopy, and up above, behind the metal grille, is a set of reliquaries said to be containing the relics of the skulls of Saint Peter and Saint Paul. Under the canopy is the papal altar at which the Pope alone was allowed to celebrate Mass. Also located within the papal altar is a wooden table that Saint Peter and many of the earliest popes are said to have celebrated the Eucharist upon. Every year on November 9th, we celebrate the feast of the dedication of St. John Lateran Basilica. The intention behind the annual feast day is to encourage Catholics to keep strong ties to our past and the Universal Catholic Church.